What is the important point? Let us try to again rearrange our thought. What is our aim? Our aim is the clear. We want a knowledge. We do not want to commit any mistake. Because knowledge is called intuitive eyes. If you are able to observe through intuition, then we cannot commit any mistake. Then how to get knowledge? Let us try to understand lamp, oil lamp. In oil lamp there is a oil, there is a cotton. Cotton and oil soak together. When you try to give a spark of the heat, take matchbox or candle, try to touch that cotton which is soaked with the oil, then you will find that now that cotton starts glowing. Then when it starts glowing, then what happens? Now it is visible. I can read newspaper in that. Before it was dark, not able to read. Now we have oil lamp. Through the oil lamp, now vision is better. That is called only little lamp. But we want a lamp within head and spine. That seven lamps has to be awakened. Therefore, remember how to do that. When there is a cotton soaked with the oil, and if it comes in contact with the spark of heat, then you will find glow. Now this cotton is glowing. It becomes burning lamp. It means what happens? The cotton and oil try to meet together. They were not able to meet together. You can squeeze the cotton, you will find oil is away. But we want complete unity. That you cannot separate it, then how to unite together? Then we need a spark of heat. When try to give the spark of heat, then they will find now oil and cotton both are trying to meet each other. When they become one, then what you find? A glow. Now that glow is light. In that there is visibility. Exactly in the same way. We want complete unity within. What is the within? Let us think head to toes. We are having bone and cartilage, muscles, skin. We have arteries and veins. So many things are there. So many organs are there. So many structures are there. We want to bring unity among them. Then how to bring unity? And in order to bring unity, there should be scientific approach. There should not be side effect. Okay, all right. Now I start running. Because when you run like marathon, then your bone and muscles and skin and arteries and veins, they are coming nearer and nearer. After that I am doing wrestling. Then I am doing cricket. I am doing basketball. I am doing volleyball. In that way what I am bringing unity, that is unscientific. In that when you leave, you suffer from blood pressure, heart disease, arthritis, many complications come. Therefore, a sports person, always you will find, end up the life is very bad. We do not want such a unity. It is better without unity. Then without unity, you cannot get the knowledge. We want knowledge. Therefore, the highest unity, high quality of unity we can achieve when you provide service. We have to serve earth. Because earth is very important, we are sitting here. When there is no earth, you cannot have the tree. And tree we need. We need food. Fruits and seeds and grains, they are important food for us. They are important food for all animals. Therefore, we have to serve earth. Then we have to serve plants, then we have to serve animals, then we have to serve human beings. But there is no climate. We are not having advantage that each and every person should be able to provide service to all. Working in the garden, means serving the plant, serving the earth, serving the animals, we don't have animals, then serving human beings, from newborn baby up to the all ages, we do not have those persons. This is very unnatural. Lifestyle is not glorified. It means the lifestyle designed by the government, designed by the administration, our modern education system is incomplete, unnatural. Therefore, we are not having opportunity to provide balanced service. Why want to give service? Because when you serve the clay, you are going to dig the clay because you want to increase fertility. That sun rays should touch each and every molecule of the clay. Air should be there. Then fertility will be better. Then we will have better crops and plants. But we do not have time. We do not have place to work. We do not have time and place. We do not have variety of the plants to serve. We don't have time. We are so much engaged in our business, in our office. We do not have time to serve animals because in serving all kinds of earth, plants, animals, human beings, from the children up to the all age, we reduce distance between bone and muscles and cartilage, between arteries and veins, between arterioles, each and every cell and tissue within head to toes, whatever we feel, whatever we experience, then we are not able to experience that because lifestyle is difficult. I am engineer in computer, day and night I am busy in computer, I am professor in IT, I don't have time to do all varieties of work, I am doctor, I don't have time to serve the plants and animals and to work with the field. Therefore, lifestyle is such a half-jerk, then we cannot feel peace and joy, we cannot get knowledge. Because knowledge will come only when try to reduce distance between cells and tissues. When they are existing, you have to reduce them. No space. Then how to do that? Therefore, we need a recharging. 1 to 42 steps is designed so that you must feel various changes in all our head to toes. Those changes are presence of more and more contact among all cells and tissues of the body in the best way. In that there is no side effect. When we are having game and sports, we get side effect. With the help of recharging, you have good effect that you rejuvenate muscles and ligaments and tendons. You are rejuvenating your bones. Your body is becoming more and more active and rejuvenated. Therefore, you should not miss a recharging 1 to 42 steps because it will compensate all incorrect lifestyle. Therefore, if anybody is practicing 2-3 times recharging very nicely, they are able to bring all structures together. But that is not sufficient. Oil and cotton are together, but we don't see the glow. We need a spark of light, a spark of heat. Therefore, when you try to practice recharging 1 to 42 steps, or practicing sitting position, all various changes, whatever we feel, try to accept all with the thought, with the principle and philosophy of Kriya Yoga. That principle and philosophy of Kriya Yoga is the spark, is the light, is the spark, is the heat which is essential to increase power and knowledge within which are sleeping, to awaken knowledge within. Then how to do that? It is very easy. Feel head to toes during 1 to 42 steps or when you are sitting, whatever you feel, accept it. Presence of God in form. What is the meaning of God? We want knowledge, you are experiencing knowledge. You want power, you are experiencing power. You want peace, you are experiencing peace. You want joy, you are experiencing that. Therefore, during practice, whatever we realize, whatever we feel, try to accept those changes with the principle and philosophy of Kriya Yoga. Principle and philosophy of Kriya Yoga is the spark of heat, which will awaken the wisdom center within, knowledge center within. Therefore, standing recharging is very important, because we are not having proper facility to provide service to all. If you want to serve animals, but you don't have tiger to serve, oh, I have pet, I have cat and dog. No, you have to serve all kind of animals. Tiger and hyena and wolf, you don't have it. Then you have to serve a whale, you have to serve all kind of animals, you can't get it. Then practice recharging. You don't need to go and dive in the ocean and, oh, welcome, I want to serve you. Oh, shark, where are you going? Then we will be injured through this shark. Tiger, where are you? Oh, come, my dear, I want to keep in my stomach. Therefore, remember, you have 1 to 42 steps. Do not worry about anything. Just practice it, and whatever changes you feel, accept those changes. Presence of power, knowledge, peace and bliss, immortality, that's all. We are very fortunate. We have not to go down into the ocean. We have not to get tiger, please come, I want to serve. We don't need. Therefore, please do not miss recharging.